Hi, everybody. If you don't know me, I'm Bob and Shirley's son. If you remember back when my father had his heart attack and we had to go for surgery, Pastor Chris said it best. The Raifsniders, he could do probably 3 years on sermons with our family, just because we've all been through a lot. And kind of, I'm getting nervous now, kind of have to paraphrase my life because we just do not have the time. I was brought up through the church. I was born into the church. We attended Central Presbyterian, Arona Square. I would say that that was the best thing to happen in our lives, because no matter what our family went through, no matter how hard it was or how everything seemed just impossible, that rock was always there. We always, always came back to family, always came back to church. I was a bit of the black sheep. I was a bit of the wild child. And big surprise, right? And I walked away from the church. I walked away from the church. I walked away from family. Walked away from my parents quite a few times. but like I said, without getting into a lot of details, no matter how bad it got, I always came back. And when I didn't come back, my father always came looking for me. Usually because mom made him. I went a different route in life than my siblings. I thought that, you know, everything was the way it was to be, that, you know, this was my purpose, this is what I'm going to do. I settled down, I met the woman of my dreams, raised her children and her family that were not mine, and one day I got a call from work, and it said, you need to get home immediately because she was in an accident, and they wouldn't give me any other details, but I found out when I got there, and I saw the corner in the driveway what had happened. And again, I walked away. I walked away from the church. And it was, I didn't walk away from my parents that time, because they were the ones that this time made sure that I was there. And because of them and, of course, my uncle, really helped me through some bad times. I've sang with angels and danced with demons. But I've always come back. And I've always come back to family, and I've always come back to church. And I've always had somebody tapping me on the shoulder saying, hey, you're not done yet. You're not done yet. I know it's bad. I know it's hard. I know you're going through a lot. But you're not done yet. So you need to pick it up, dust yourself off, and get back to where you need to be. And I've traveled that merry-go-round many years, many years. I've put my parents through a lot, many years. And I just needed to let them know that I love them. I'm very happy being back with the church again. I'm not going to walk away again. And through all that I've been through, I just feel that I've been constantly being pushed this direction to this church and this congregation and becoming a part of it and doing what I do, which I don't think I do anything, but apparently somebody else thinks that I do. So that's kind of it in the handbag. Like I said, we really don't have time for me to get into details. I could write a very, very long, extensive miniseries. So I would just like to say that, you know, One thing my parents always worried about when we were growing up was that they didn't spend enough time with us, that they didn't think that we got the love and the attention from them, because they worked very, very, very hard raising all of us kids. And I just wanted to let them know, especially now with my father and his big 75th birthday, that your love and attention never went wasted. It was always there. We always knew that. And we weren't the best of kids sometimes, and we rebelled, and as most kids do, but because of the faith and the love that you had in God and Jesus Christ and church, bringing that to us as children and growing us to the point where you said, now it's your choice, you know, which is what it was. It was, you're old enough now to make your own decisions. We didn't necessarily make the best ones, did we? But it was because of you too, you know, through him, that made us what we are today. And I'm very thankful for that. And I love you both very, very much. And this was never, ever wasted, ever. So, there it is. I'm done.